black glass is showing another room. Must be a way to another one of Jeremy's memories.
I knew it would work. You're getting good at this, Carnby. Maybe a little too good at this. Hartwood's family crypt. Emily's family must have deeper roots in New Orleans than I thought. I figured she was a Yankee like me. This? Now, what do we got here? Got it. Thank you.
I'm all out of bullets.
Jeremy sketched this chapel in his book, so it must be important. Looks like I'll need more medallions to open it, though. I don't think I have everything I need. Thank you. It's blocked.
many of them. I've got to get out of here. Many of them. I gotta get out of here. Many of them. I gotta get out of here.
Okay, wait, now I'm questioning which way to go because there's so many different branches of tunnel, it seems. Now I'm doubting myself here.
Many of them. I gotta get out of here.
Now what do we got here? Thank God that's over.
Please don't touch her.
Jeremy. What are you doing here? Everyone's looking for you.
I know. It's all a big mess. No one understands. I'm just trying to keep evil at bay. Just for a little while longer.
You've got to come back with me. Your niece is waiting at Dorsetto.
Emily? Why would you...
My letter.
I keep making it worse.
What is going on, Jeremy? How is any of this happening?
I made a terrible promise with someone.
The Dark Man. Who is he?
No, don't say his name. He can hear us.
He's always listening. Jeremy, I need to understand what is going on.
I promised him everything. When the sun rises, I will be chained in his sunken desert temple for an eternity. But at least the evil about to awaken in Dorsetto won't harm anyone outside of that cursed place.
You're acting crazy, Jeremy. I want to help.
There's nothing you can do.
And what's all the business about Terroea? Why did you want to go there?
Well, I can't go there. I'm not allowed.
But you wanted to. Can I go? Tell me, will it help me to break your pact? Is there something there that would help?
Why would you give me hope? That's so cruel.
Okay. Sounds like we're onto something here. What should I...
Look out! Behind you!
What?
Run! Don't let it take you! I've seen so many strange occurrences lately. Memories explode into existence and then burn out like tied glass bulb filaments. Dreamscapes crash down from the stars and sink into the sea. Doors that lead to nowhere and absolutely everywhere at once. With all this reverie, I want to think there's a chance that you found a way to remain alive in some way I cannot fathom. Just like I've learned to navigate with my talisman, maybe you, with all your knowledge, you somehow knew a way. A way to find me again, perhaps in Terroea. Oh, my love. Jeremy.
She's dead. No matter how she died, she looks peaceful now. telescope lens. Why would he lock that up?
I'm not gonna walk out of this now. I need to help Emily save her uncle.
I need the key. Whoa, what's going on? It's dialing in something all on its own and it's showing the way to another memory? Where is that? Thank you. we go.
I'm glad to see you made it. I had my doubts, but the hope you instilled has yet abandoned me.
I guess this must be Tarawea.
Who are you?
My name is Juan Luis Jorge, and this is indeed the convent of Tarawea. You'll have to excuse me, but Yermi never got your name.
The name's Edward Carnby. I'm a private investigator. You're not a patient, are you?
No. I'm the author of a book that Yermi once found important.
How does that work? Are you part of this memory as well? Is this even a memory?
I think calling me a manifestation of Yermi's subconscious would be more correct. And so is the convent of Tarawea. I'm a man Yermi has never met. And we are in a place that he has never been.
Okay. So are you here to guide me or something?
I have no more purpose than you do. I simply am. I will happily help you, of course, if I'm able.
If you are already somehow part of Jeremy, why did he want to come here? Isn't he sort of here already?
Yermi wanted to come here because it's a representation of his mind at peace. When Dr. Gray asks him to find his focus during his sessions, this far-flung convent is what Yermi imagines. He is under the impression that if he could physically come here, he would reach a perfect equanimity. A spiritual apotheosis.
You don't think it would work?
Yermi subconsciously knows it's just wishful thinking. He can't come here. Despite the pathways opened by the dark man between Derceto and Yermi's psyche, it's simply not possible.
But I'm here.
Indeed. It's a shame it's just another place for you, Detective. Otherwise, you could have become a Buddha.
Always a bridesmaid, never a blushing bride. Am I right?
Yes, I suppose so. You'll have to chase enlightenment elsewhere.
So what's the next best thing? What can I do here?
You should seek out the convent library and try to find the truth about Yermi's relationship with the Dark Man. It's the sort of knowledge he represses and is unable to reflect on.
Will it tell me how to break the pact?
Perhaps. At least you'll have something to confront Yermi with.
Wait, why can't you just tell me?
I don't know such things. You'd be better off consulting the texts of Dr. Freud if you want such answers.
No thanks, I hate shrinks.
There is another thing you should know about the library. He is here as well. The Dark Man has been working his way through the texts for a long, long time.
He's here? How am I supposed to get past him?
Be careful, Detective.
Oh, jeez. Just perfect. You have any advice on how to deal with the Dark Man?
I suppose suppression could work. Try not to pay him any attention.
There's something missing.
Great library was endless, beautiful, and terrible. An Akashic record for the... The great library was endless, beautiful, and terrible. An Akashic record for the universe inside the mind of Jeremy Hartwood. Now corrupted by a story forced upon him, told by a maniacal liar. An evil conjured by science and secrecy. I will suspend a room and lock away the foundation of his character. Its key will be left to the librarian, the only thing invisible to the prowler.
Why do you have to manifest your worst fears, Jeremy?
How did I even die? I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Also, don't trust these statues here. I think I've been playing too much Resident Evil.
There's something missing.
Oh, shit. Why do you have to manifest your worst fears, Jeremy?
Man, he's creeping me out. Can you just go away somewhere? Oh my gosh, I'm gonna die. Am I gonna get past him? He's coming.
was in the hot autumn that I went through the night with the restless crowds. He was a kind of itinerant showman who held forth in public halls and aroused widespread fear. The New Orleans address of the event is lost, but I remember distinctly the Prext Shipping Company pressing their contribution.
Hey.
Detective!
Juan! Juan!
I hope you found what you were looking for. I fear there is no going back.
I was so close. It must be something I can work with. Come on, Garmby, think. Think! The shipping company. Prext. Right.
Good luck, detective.
Well, thank God you're here, detective. Sitting all alone in a place like this. I'd never live it down if the papers got wind of it.
Hey. Ruth, right?
Oh, don't pretend you don't know. I'm sure you have a whole file on me by now, Detective. I suppose we weren't formally introduced. I'm Ruth Talon. Miss Ruth Talon, in case you're wondering.
Edward Carnby.
Enchanté.
You sure?
I had too many already.
Nice. It's good.
I know. I have great taste, Detective. I heard you're trying to break Jeremy's promise.